Welcome to this short presentation on costs and benefits of safety, in which I present some basic concepts, tools, and approaches. My name is Jens-Erik Reniers. I'm a professor of safety of hazardous materials at the Delft University of Technology. As already mentioned in other presentations, new technologies which we are developing should respect the values which we hold dear. One of these values is safety. However, safety has a cost as well as a benefit. Research on responsible innovation therefore includes a proper economic evaluation of the safety aspects related to the new technologies that we develop. With an economic assessment of a technical innovation, we aim to estimate and judge the costs and the benefits accompanying the risks which this new technology could entail. For this, we need to know the following basic important concepts. Principle of cost-benefit analysis, types of events that can occur, the net present value, the cost of prevention, avoided costs of accidents or hypothetical benefits, and the disproportion factor. Let us now address them in turn, starting with the principles of a cost-benefit analysis for safety. A cost-benefit analysis is an economic evaluation in which all costs and all consequences of a certain decision are expressed in the same units, usually money. A cost-benefit analysis cannot demonstrate whether one safety investment is intrinsically better than another. Nonetheless, a cost-benefit analysis allows decision makers to improve their decisions by adding appropriate information on the costs and benefits to certain prevention or mitigation investment decisions. Since decisions on safety investments involve choices between different possible risk management options, cost-benefit analysis can be very useful. They are basically used to determine whether an investment represents an efficient use of resources. Decisions may be straightforward in some cases, but this may not always be true. For example, due to different existing types of unwanted events. Type 1 unwanted events can be regarded as occupational accidents, for example, accidents resulting in the inability to work for several days, accidents requiring first aid, and others. Type 2 events can be categorized as major accidents, for example, multiple fatality accidents, accidents with huge economic costs, etc. Type 2 events are just surrounded with more uncertainty. Type 3 events can be regarded as so-called black swans. For type 3 events, no information whatsoever is available, so an economic analysis cannot be determined, cannot be carried out for such type of event. In case of type 2 and type 1 events, the economic considerations which are made are somewhat different. For type 2 events, a disproportion factor can be used, as we will see. Third is the concept of the net present value. A safety investment project represents an allocation of means, such as money and time in the present, that will result in a particular stream of hypothetical benefits in the future. The main purpose of the safety cost-benefit analysis is to obtain relevant information about the level and distribution of benefits and costs of safety. Through this information, a safety investment decision can be guided and made in a more objective way. The analysis role is thus to provide the possibility of a more objective evaluation and not to adopt an advocacy position either in favor or against the safety investment. As there are also many other aspects that should be taken into account when deciding about safety investments, such as, for example, social acceptability, ethical issues, regulatory affairs, philosophical affairs, etc. If a decision maker uses a cost-benefit analysis, the recommendation whether to accept or to reject an investment project is based upon the following process. Identification of costs and benefits, calculation of the present values of all costs and benefits, and comparison of the present values of total costs and total benefits, determining the net present value. In order to compare the total costs and the total benefits composed out of costs and benefits occurring at different points in time, we need to take a discount rate into account in the calculation in order to obtain the present values. We thus need to convert all cash flows from both costs and benefits in the future to values in the present. The discount rate represents the rate at which we are willing to give up consumption in the present in exchange for additional consumption in the future. Another way of seeing this is that people value future experiences to a lesser degree than present ones, as they are sure about the present events and not sure about future events. The higher the discount rate, the lower the present values of the future cash flows. An investment project is recommended when the total net present value of all cash flows is positive. The formula usually mentioned to calculate the net present value is the one you see now on the screen. Where XT represents the cash flow in year T, capital T is the time period considered, usually expressed in years, and R is the discount rate. Applied to safety, the net present value of a safety investment expresses the difference between the total discounted present value of the benefits and the total discounted present value of the costs. A positive net present value for a certain safety investment indicates that the project benefits are larger than the costs, under the assumptions that are made, of course. Fourth are the costs of safety measures. One can distinguish a great variety of costs associated with a safety investment, as you can see on the slide, and we may conveniently classify them into a few clear categories. For example, initial costs, installation costs, operating costs, maintenance costs, inspection costs, and what have you. These costs are evidently represented by negative cash flows. Some costs, for example, the initial costs and the installation costs, occur in the present and thus do not have to be discounted, while other costs, for example, the operating costs, the maintenance and the inspection costs, they occur throughout the whole remaining lifetime of the facility and thus they will have to be discounted to the present. Fifth are hypothetical benefits. There are different categories of benefits linked to a safety investment. But how can we interpret benefits? Well, the purpose of safety investments is to reduce present and future accidents. Thus, the benefits are hypothetical, since the accidents, or rather accident scenarios, never occurred. And they are defined by the difference in consequences without and with a safety investment, and if applicable, taking into account the difference in likelihood. Since there are usually a large number of accident scenarios avoided, the hypothetical benefits will be much larger than the accident costs calculated for one accident scenario. A way to look at this is that the only most probable accident scenario will happen in reality, but many more have been avoided. But the analogy, I think, is clear. Hypothetical benefits or avoided accident costs can be diverse, such as supply chain benefits, damage benefits, legal benefits, insurance benefits, human and environmental benefits, intervention benefits, reputation benefits, and other benefits. The benefits represent positive cash flows, which all occur in the future and thus will have to be discounted to the present. As with the costs, we may also conveniently classify the benefits into a few clear categories, for example, supply chain, damage, legal, insurance, human, environmental, and reputation benefits. Sixth and finally is a disproportion factor. The cash flows, prevention costs, and certainly the hypothetical benefits may be uncertain. Different approaches can then be used to deal with this fact. The cash flows can, for example, be expressed as expected values, taking the uncertainties in the form of probabilities into account, and also increasing the discount rate to outweigh the possibilities for unfavorable outcomes. This is possible for uncertain, that is, the more severe type 1 risks. However, in case of type 2 risks, the major accident risks, we can use scenario analysis, estimating cash flows for different scenario cases, for example, worst case accident or most credible case accident scenarios, and using a so-called disproportion factor. Type 2 risks or major accident risks are related to extremely low frequencies and a high level of uncertainty. To take this into account, the cost-benefit analysis preferably involves a disproportion factor in order to reflect an intended bias in favor of safety above costs. If this equation is true, then the safety investment under consideration is not reasonably practicable, as the costs of the safety measure are disproportionate to its hypothetical benefits. In order to give an idea about the size of the disproportion factor, guidelines state that disproportion factors are rarely greater than 10. and that the higher the risk, the higher the disproportion factor should be, in order to stress the magnitude of those risks in the cost-benefit analysis. This means that in cases where the risk is very high, it might be acceptable to use a disproportion factor greater than 10. So, with this last message, I thank you very much for watching.